Welcome back. Black history, clearly part of America's history, but during the month of February, the nation pauses to recognize the achievements of blacks in America. This month, right here on BTN, we've highlighted Minnesotans making a difference. And several of you have asked via email, why do we celebrate black history in the shortest month of the calendar year? You will find out at the end of this next story. Let's go now to St. Paul. That's the bell signaling class is in session. Today's lesson.
What month is this?
Black History Month.
Students, 19 seventh and eighth graders at Highland Middle School in St. Paul.
Black History Month is a way that we learn about inventions that we weren't taught, learn about people that we wouldn't normally be taught about in school.
Little do people know, a black man created one of the first traffic lights. But that's not it. We've contributed with so much more. Even the mop that helps you clean your floor and the refrigerator door.
I can agree sometimes because, you know, you don't really see a lot of African-American voices in, like, history books.
All we learn about is slavery.
Do you all know who Rosa Parks is?
Yes.
Do you know who Dr. King is?
Yes.
Stand up if you know why we celebrate Black History in the month of February. Stand up if you know why we celebrate Black History Month. Sit down if you know who created peanut butter. Who created peanut butter?
George Washington Carver.
And who was George Washington Carver?
He was a black scientist who worked with peanuts and created things with them.
What do you do to cool off when it's hot outside?
Water guns.
Lonnie G. Johnson is a former Air Force and NASA engineer who invented the popular Super Soaker water gun. Speaking of water.
Do you guys think Black History Month has been watered down?
Yeah.
We don't really go beyond the surface of African-American studies. You kind of stay on, like Rosa Parks, Dr. Martin Luther King and stuff.
It's just shocking when you learn about all these historic and wonderful events that have happened because of black people and you don't learn about in school.
I learned who John Lewis was. I didn't know he was like a congressman.
Let's go back to our first question, which none of the students could answer. Why do we celebrate the achievements of blacks in February? They grab their phones and iPads and learn.
It used to be a week. Which is what I found out.
1 week, a Harvard scholar and son of former slaves, Carter G. Woodson, founded. First, it was called Negro History Week, a period that coincided with two special birthdays.
I learned that Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln, they were born the same week.
Everyone knows the story of President Lincoln, and Frederick Douglass escaped slavery and later became an abolitionist. During the civil rights movement of the 60s, Negro History Week evolved into Black History Month. President Gerald R. Ford officially recognized Black History Month in 1976. Now, as the pages of history honor the past.
Slavery, that was a really dark time and stuff, but you kind of have to go through the bumps and stuff to get to the brighter future.
These 19 are dreaming of their future.
So the students are not, they want to go beyond scratching the surface, which is what we do often, is scratch the surface. We learn a little bit. And when I first got there, they said, hey, we don't like boring conversation. We want to get to the meat. We don't like watered down conversation.
Wow.
So I learned from them. I got just as much out of it as I hope you are getting out of this at home.
And they learned too. They were forced to get some lessons they didn't have. I was impressed that the girl knew the peanut butter one.
Oh yeah.
That's a deep dive.
Deep.
Yeah. All right. Let's stay.